focus a little bit and focus on natural resources and also the connection with climate change. So I want to kind of center us by going back again to Laudato Si and Pope Francis and his call to all of us to care for our common home and one another. It's been mentioned earlier throughout earlier today how many times Pope Francis says in the encyclical that everything is connected, right? We are connected, humanity and nature. We have a close, interdependent relationship with one another. We have one crisis that is social and environmental and requires an integrated response. And Pope Francis brings us this challenge to turn away from what he calls a culture of waste or a throwaway culture, right, that discards not only people and natural resources, and to embrace a culture of solidarity and encounter, right? So to move away from kind of this short-term model of economic development, which prioritizes profit over humanity and the common good, and to move towards this culture of solidarity with one another, and particularly with the poor and vulnerable who are most impacted, most affected by environmental harm, environmental degradation, and climate change. So through our work alongside local affected communities and native peoples and with Jesuit partners around the world, we have witnessed the destructive impacts of an economy of exclusion, how the extraction of natural resources brings social conflict, leads to the criminalization of those who defend their environmental and human rights, leads to the displacement of people from their homes and lands, contaminates air and water, and contributes to deforestation and climate change. Today, I'm pleased to have with us members and partners of the Jesuit Network who have witnessed and are working together to respond to these challenges and to accompany the most vulnerable. Today we have with us William Costa. Willie is the Executive Director of the Micronesia Conservation Trust, an organization supporting community sustainability. And he served in that position since 2006. We also have on the other end Dr. Xavier Sawayunzu, who is a Jesuit priest and a chair and a professor within the Department of Environmental Studies at St. Xavier's College in Calcutta, India. On November 1st, he will become the Vice President of St. Xavier's College. His research focuses on drinking water, arsenic contamination, and the cancer and public health impacts of this contamination. Next to him is Pedro Landa. Pedro is the coordinator of the Jesuit Network for Human Rights and Integral Ecology for the Jesuit Conference of Latin America and the Caribbean. He's also a member of the Global Donation Advocacy Network, Justice in Mining. Pedro has worked for 20 years in Latin America with social and ecclesial networks to expose the corruption, impunity, and violence surrounding the extraction of natural resources and minerals. Since 2006, he's worked to investigate Canadian mining operations and to expose their environmental and human rights violations. He's helped to bring these concerns before the American Commission on Human Rights in Honduras and Latin America. Next to him is Alicia Alemán Arastillo. Alicia is the networking and advocacy officer for the international development non-governmental organization called ALGOAN. Aguan means next to, or close to, proximate to in Basque. And she is a member also of the Ignatian Global Advocacy Network, Justice in Miami. Finally, we have Father Rigobert Minani Ihuzo. Rigobert is a Jesuit father from the Congo. He currently coordinates the Jesuit Social Apostolate in Africa, Madagascar. He also is the team leader of the Ecclesial Network of the Congo Basin Forest. So please join me in welcoming our panelists.